Blackstone Publishing presents The Bookwoman of Troublesome Creek, a novel by Kim Michele Richardson. This book is read by Katie Schorr. For Stacy Testa, a dear bookwoman. The very existence of libraries affords the best evidence that we may yet have hope for the future of man. T.S. Eliot. Kentucky, 1936. The librarian and her mule spotted it at the same time. The creature's ears shot up, and it came to a stop so sudden its front hooves skidded out, the pannier slipping off, spilling out the librarian's books. An eddy of dirt and debris lifted, stinging the woman's eyes. The mule struggled to look upward, backward, anywhere other than at the thing in front of it. The bookwoman couldn't keep her eyes off the spectacle as she shortened the reins and clamped her legs against the mule's sides. Again, she prodded her mount. Bearing tall, sassing teeth, the beast lifted its muzzle into the balsam-sweetened air, the quavering brays blistering the sleepy mountain. The woman stiffened, drawing the reins in tighter. In front of her, a body swayed back and forth below the fat branch from which it hung. A rope, collared tight around the neck, creaked from the strain of its weight. A kettle of turkey buzzards circled above, dipping their ugly, naked heads toward the lifeless form, their tail-chasing shadows riddling the dying grass. From the scorched earth rose strange cries, and the librarian pulled her stunned gaze away from the corpse and toward the ground. Beside a large toppled can, a baby lay in the dirt, the tiny face pinched, scalded with fury. Mountain breezes dipped lazily, shifting, carrying the stench of death and its soiling. The weighted branch crackled, groaning under its burden. A bloodied sock inched down from a limp, cerulean blue foot. The librarian gawked at the striking blue flesh and cupped a hand over her mouth. The stocking slipped off, landing beside the squalling baby's head. The wind rose higher, then plunged, skittering across the sock as if trying to lift it, but it stayed stubbornly put, rooted to the earth, too heavy to be sent off by a mere summer breeze. The bookwoman looked up, lifted one darkening hand in front of her own blue-colored face, as if comparing her color to that of the hanging corpse. She examined her cobalt-blue flesh, then dared to peek back up at the dead body. Bound, eternally rooted like the black oak to the hard, everlasting Kentucky land so many tried so hard to escape. Chapter 1. The new year was barely 15 hours old in Troublesome Creek, Kentucky, when my pa adjusted the courting candle, setting it to burn for an alarming length of time. Satisfied, Pa carried it out of our one-room log house and onto the hand-hewn porch. He was hopeful, hoping 1936 was the year his only daughter, 19-year-old Cussy Mary Carter, would get herself hitched and quit her job with the Packhorse Library Project, hoping for her latest suitor's proposal. "Cussy," he called over his shoulder, "before your mama passed, I promised her I'd see to it you got yourself respectability, but I've nearly gone busted buying candles to get you some. Let this stick hold the fire, daughter." He hoisted the old wrought iron candle holder higher by its iron-forged rat tail and once more played with the wooden slide, moving the taper up and down inside the spiral coil. "I've got a respectable life," I said quietly, following him out to the porch, taking a seat on the wooden chair and huddling under the patchwork eiderdown I'd dragged along. The first day of January had brought a skift of snow to our home in the cove. Pa set the candle down and struck a match to light a lantern hanging from the porch. Two winter moths chased the light, circling, landing nearby. A clean wedding mingled into wood smoke, an umbrella.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.